You're listening to MedSchool Radio, bringing you the best in medicine.
Welcome back to MedSchool Radio. We are looking at the immunology chapter of First Aid 2020, page 114 and 115. We're going to look at blood transfusion reactions and also the autoantibodies. So let's start with the blood transfusion reactions: allergic anaphylactic reaction, acute hemolytic transfusion reactions, febrile non-hemolytic transfusion reactions, transfusion related acute lung injury, and delayed hemolytic transfusion reaction. Okay, first, allergic or anaphylactic reaction. Remember, this is a type 1 hypersensitivity reaction against plasma proteins in transfused blood. IgA deficient individuals should receive blood products without IgA. The timing is within minutes to 2 to 3 hours, which is due to release of preformed inflammatory mediators in degranulating mast cells. The clinical presentation: for allergies, urticaria, pruritus. For anaphylaxis, you'd have wheezing, hypotension, respiratory arrest, and shock. For acute hemolytic transfusion reaction, this is the type 2 hypersensitivity reaction, typically causes intravascular hemolysis, ABO, blood group incompatibility. The timing is during transfusion or within 24 hours due to preformed antibodies. Clinical presentation here: fever, hypotension, tachypnea, tachycardia, flank pain, hemoglobinuria, intravascular, and jaundice, which is extravascular. For febrile non-hemolytic transfusion reaction, pathogenesis: cytokines created by donor white blood cells accumulate during storage of blood products. The reaction is prevented by leukoreduction of blood products. Timing here is within 1 to 6 hours, which is due to preformed cytokines. And there would be fever, headaches, chills, flushing, and it is more common in children. So that was febrile non-hemolytic transfusion reaction. Next is transfusion-related acute lung injury. This is the two-hit mechanism. First, neutrophils are sequestered and primed in pulmonary vasculature due to recipient risk factors. Neutrophils are activated by a product, for example, anti-leukocyte antibodies in the transfused blood, and release inflammatory mediators, which leads to an increase in capillary permeability, which leads to pulmonary edema. This is within minutes to 6 hours. The clinical presentation here: respiratory distress, non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema. So that was transfusion-related acute lung injury. And lastly, for the blood transfusion reactions, delayed hemolytic transfusion reaction: anamnestic response to a foreign antigen on donor red blood cells, most commonly Rh or other minor blood group antigens previously encountered by recipient, typically causes extravascular hemolysis. The onset here is over 24 hours, usually presents within 1 to 2 weeks due to slow destruction by reticuloendothelial system. Clinical presentation: generally self-limited and clinically silent. There would be mild fever and hyperbilirubinemia. Okay, that was the blood transfusion reactions. Now let's go over to page 115. We're going to look at the autoantibodies. So the way it's presented here is on the left, autoantibody, and on the right, associated disorder. But I'm going to do it oppositely. So we're going to say the disorder, and you have to guess what the antibody is. Okay, first, myasthenia gravis, anti-postsynaptic acetylcholine receptor, Lambert-Eaton myasthenic syndrome, anti-presynaptic voltage-gated calcium channel, anti-phospholipid syndrome, anti-beta-2 glycoprotein 1. Non-specific screening antibody often associated with SLE. Anti-nuclear, ANA. Next, SLE antiphospholipid syndrome. Antibody is anticardiolipin, lupus anticoagulant. How about for SLE? Anti-dsDNA, anti-Smith. Next, drug-induced lupus, antihistone. Mixed connective tissue disease, anti-U1-RNP, ribonucleoprotein. Rheumatoid arthritis, rheumatoid factor, IgM antibody against IgG Fc region, and anti-CCP, which is more specific. Next, Sjögren syndrome, anti-RO-SSA, and anti-LA-SSB. Next is scleroderma, which is diffuse, anti-SCL-70, anti-DNA, topoisomerase 1. Next one, limited scleroderma, Kress syndrome, anti-centromere. Next, polymyositis, dermatomyositis. Anti-synthetase, for example, anti-JO1, anti-SRP, anti-helicase, which is anti-MI2. Next one, primary biliary cholangitis, anti-mitochondrial antibody. Next one, autoimmune hepatitis type 1, anti-smooth muscle and autoantibody. Next disorder, microscopic polyangiitis, eosinophilic granulomatosis with polyangiitis, which is Churg-Strauss syndrome, and ulcerative colitis. The antibody here is MPO ANCA / PANCA. Next, granulomatosis with polyangiitis. This is Wegener's. PR3-ANCA/CANCA. Next, primary membranous nephropathy. This is antiphospholipase A2 receptor. Bullous pemphigoid. This is anti-hemidesmosome antibody. Pemphigus vulgaris. This is anti-desmoglein, which is anti-desmosome antibody. Next one, Hashimoto thyroiditis. Anti-thyroglobulin, anti-thyroid peroxidase, which is antimicrosomal. Next one, Graves' disease, anti-TSH receptor, celiac disease, IgA anti-endosomal, endomysial, IgA anti-tissue transglutaminase, IgA and IgG deamidated gliadin peptide. That's for celiac disease. Next one, type 1 diabetes mellitus, anti-glutamic acid decarboxylase, islet cell cytoplasmic antibodies. Next one, pernicious anemia. This is anti-parietal cell, anti-intrinsic factor autoantibody. And last one, good pasture syndrome. The antibody here is anti-glomerular basement membrane. Thanks for tuning in.